Because of what Jesus brought to you and me that first Christmas night. Aren't you thankful for joy? Amen? Amen. And you may be seated in this place this evening. Christmas is my favorite time of year. I love everything about it, from the food, the gifts, the gathering, everything there is about the Christmas season. I love it. And these children this evening, they're going to remind us a little bit about what Christmas is all about. Because Christmas is a lot of things, but the main thing tonight, the main thing that we want to be reminded of is Christmas is Jesus. So you listen closely tonight as these children remind us of what Christmas is.
Snow's gonna fall and praying for some place to park at the mall. It's all going crazy 'cause it's
Christmas is almost here, as they just reminded us. It's just like right around the corner. Is anybody ready? Anybody got? Yeah, I know, right? I'm not ready either, but I am ready. I love the Christmas season. I love the reminder of what these boys and girls just shared with us. Christmas is Jesus. Can we thank these guys and gals once again? Great job, boys and girls. So proud of you. So proud of you. Moms and dads, I'm going to invite you to stand to your feet, just the moms and dad at this time. They're going to make their way back to you at this time. So boys and girls, go ahead and make your ways back to moms and dads. We'll get set up for our next song. Christmas is Jesus. There's my helpers. They're great helpers right there, too. Oh, it was a night unlike any other. The angels sang, the shepherds came. We read the story, and we heard the story just a moment ago. We're going to hear that story all throughout this evening, but it's a story that changes lives. It's a story that meets us where we are, but it changes us from the inside out. It was what one song says was a silent night, but it was also a holy night. When heaven met earth, when grace met us where we were, it was a holy night. I'm going to invite you to stand to your feet once again and join us as we sing about that holy night.
Your name.
Be seated. He could have come in any way, but yet he came in such a simple way. He's King of Kings and Lord of Lords, but yet he came like anyone else came. But it was a miraculous birth. You see, Mary was a virgin, and the Lord visited her. And I'm so thankful for all that we read in the Word of God. King of Kings stepped down from glory for you and for me, and there was a night like no other in simplicity. It wasn't, there was no pomp and circumstance to his coming. The sky was not lit up but by angels to a field of shepherds, the lowliest. He could have told the whole world he was coming, but he met with shepherds, the lowliest of the low. A simple way. He came for you and me. When I think about Christmas, when I think about Jesus coming, aren't you thankful that he came in such a simple way? Because he was a humble shepherd. He wasn't one to say, hey, look at me. He was humble. He wanted people to be drawn to him because he is worthy of our worship. And I'm thankful tonight that we can come before him and we can worship him just for who he is. And I'm thankful for that first Christmas that he came.
When I think upon Jesus,
the Savior of heaven, the Savior of earth, the Savior of you, the Savior of me has come. And it came to pass in those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This census first took place while Quirinius was governing Syria. So all went to be registered, everyone to his own city. Joseph also went up from Galilee out of the city of Nazareth into Judea to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and the lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed wife, who was with child. So it was that while she was there, the days were completed for her to be delivered, and she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. Can you imagine that first Christmas night? No room in the inn. They'd all come to Bethlehem for the census, and they got into town, and there was no place to stay, and she's great with child. The Savior of the world, she's carrying God's own son, and there's no place for him. So Jesus was born into a manger. Now, that's the story we typically read at Christmas, but let's back up just a few months before, because the stage had to be set. There were some things that God had to put in place. There were some things that needed to be orchestrated behind the scenes before this night could come to pass. You see, God had to send an angel to a young maiden and say, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy." Fear not. God had to send an angel, Gabriel, to a young man who was supposed to be marrying a young girl. And he said, "Fear not." The stage had to be set for this night to happen. God had to orchestrate so many things. And so for just a moment, can we just go back in our minds and think of what that conversation may have been like between the angel Gabriel and Mary and Joseph?
Be great, the Son of God Most High, and he shall reign, his kingdom shall have no
end. Just a simple girl from a said it's all right. Sweet Mary carries God's own sign, and you shall
bear a sign.
Don't be afraid, take Mary to be. Angel spoke to me last night. The Lord is with you.
The Lord is with you.
I'm just a simple girl from a simple world.
An angel spoke to me.
How can
said it's all right.
Emmanuel, God with us, the Lord is with you. It was an announcement that came to Mary that night. Fear not, the Lord is with you. It was an announcement that came to Joseph that night. Fear not, for I'm with you. It's an announcement tonight that comes to you. Fear not. Fear not, for he is with you. No matter what storms come your way, no matter what situations may be raised in your heart and in your life, the Lord is with you. Emmanuel, God with us. He's not a God that won't allow you to come to him, but he invites us to come to him. Aren't you thankful for that? He opens his arms up and says, come unto me, all of you who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you. Learn of me. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. That's Emmanuel, God with us. And he invites us, you and me, to come and adore him for who he is. Don't be afraid. The Lord is with you.
Humbly you came.
Would you sing this tonight, church? Understand all of that, how he was fully God yet fully man, but I believe it with all of my heart. Fully God yet fully man. He came and he made a way for you and me, and that way started in a manger. I'm thankful for that way. He is the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father except through him. I'm so thankful for that way in the manger, amen. I want you to sing this with us tonight. Lord Jesus, we love you. Oh, we love you tonight. Thank you for coming and making a way where there was no way. Thank you for that thrill of hope. Thank you that heaven met earth. We love you, Lord. We glorify you. We worship you.
Oh,
Bethlehem. So much going on in that town at that time. So many people, so much busyness and activity, and the Savior of the world came, and so many of them missed it. I wonder how many of us miss it in this day and time because of the busyness in our lives. We don't slow down enough to take the time to sit and recognize that He is Emmanuel. He is a part of our life. He is our life. And He longs to lead us and guide us and show us the way where there seems to be no way. I pray that this year, this Christmas, we won't miss Him, but we'll allow Him to lead us and guide us, that we won't miss Him, but He will be truly our Emmanuel. Oh, little town of Bethlehem, how still we see. Some fears met right there in Him.
Oh, holy child of Bethlehem, descend to us, we pray. Cast out our sin and injury. Be born in us today. We hear the Christmas angels, the great glad tidings tell. Oh, come to us, abide with us, our Lord Emmanuel.
Our Lord God with us. The light shines in the darkness. He is the light of the world, the light that came. And when He came, that darkness dispersed. And even today in our lives, when the darkness comes, we can speak the name of Jesus and that light disperses. Aren't you thankful for the name that's above every name? And He shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. That's who He is. Do you know Him today? Have you placed your faith and your trust in Him? as your Savior, your Lord. It can't be someone else. It has to be your decision. He loves you. He came for you. And he is a light in this dark world. He'll lead you. He'll guide you. He'll make your path straight. And he'll walk with you all the way. He is the light of the world.
The world waits for a miracle. The heart longs for a little bit of hope. Oh, come, Emmanuel. A child prays for peace on earth, and she's calling out from a sea of hurt. Oh, come, Emmanuel. The tears of a mother, a baby's cry is the sound of